How are we doing?
And welcome.
Where are we?
We're in there.
Greyfriar.
Greyfriar pub in Reading. So this pub is just brand newly opened, just after Christmas, January time, so very, very new pub.
Oh, I'm blue.
We've already had 2 beers. Kevin Bucks on his ticket beer.
Yeah!
Let's try.
There we go. Can you see?
Little trimmings.
Yeah.
On tap.
And very, very good.
Yeah.
8.5%. How good is it? Wonderful. Big, deep, again, golden cornflake notes.
Yeah.
What you expect from beer like this, a Belgian beer. Belgian yeast.
What's the review on this?
8.5.
I don't think you get the...
Nah, you don't. But is it a solid beer? This, to me, as an Irishman, I love my strong beers. This is a session beer. It's a very good beer.
Well, I'm trying here, Triple Brewery. I think it's the first one I've tried of theirs.
Oh, you've had it before.
I don't know, unless I've seen it.
You know, you went some of the
Triple F?
Yeah.
What beer is it?
Anyway, it's the Ramble Tamble, and it's coming at 5%. It can smell like an Amarillo Gold.
Yeah, it's about 6 cask ales.
Yeah,
they've got a modern keg line, which is
a dream. Yeah.
It's a new system that should be going out to all pubs, really.
Yeah. So they've got about 6 keg beers and ciders. They've got Hogsback as a Hogsback Brewery cider. They've got got Belgian beers, and they have other English lagers as well. Very good.
Is it try the Triple F? Triple F is local to...
It's a local brewery?
Yeah.
So, yeah. So, again, you know, local ale.
It's a slight heavy caramel backbone, but it starts off a little bit of fennel in there.
Yeah. And there's peach as well.
Yeah.
A little bit of different.
It's a lot of moist peach rather than dry peach.
Yeah.
But a lot of beers, you get more dry peach. The beer.
One thing, I've had this beer quite a lot of times. The beer for me is a very dry beer in the context of the bitterness.
Yeah.
It's quite a sessionable.
The end tension is pretty solid. I mean, the less than the glass.
So just have a look at that. You know, it's you know, older beers are very, very good that way. What they always put in their beers wheat, which gives the head retention as well. But again, there's a touch of like brown sugar to the beer.
Not brown sugar, it's almost like low-cal brown sugar. It's like in the brown sugar mark, but just underneath.
Yeah, so, you know, again, it's a very, very good beer, and it's got this wonderful, wonderful, earthy, hoppiness to it as well. It's very, very good.
Now, this is one that was on, I wanted to try, because it's, we try a lot of on bottle, but we don't try that many on tap. The ones I tried on tap recently, previous years, I mean, that's great, so I wanted to try the
Otley Brewery. So which one is it? It's not Oxymoron, is it?
From...
Andrew, which one is it?
It's the Black IPA.
Yeah, Oxymoron, yeah.
And for Black IPA, it's not as rich and robust and pungent.
So on the nose, you get very much like very up liquid. You know what I mean? That washing up liquid. On the taste?
It's not as pungent as it should be.
It's very bland.
I mean,
a bit of lemon, over sweet malts.
Mm.
I've had the bottle version, it's 10 times better than the cask version. But that's quite bitter and a little bit sour as well.
But not in a good way, because normally a black IPA is quite sour, but it's tart.
You know, with the Otley Brewery, to me it's always very, very hit and miss. You know what I mean?
Now, both of you explained to people at home, all the million and million people are watching my videos. What is an oxymoron?
Sure, Pickard. An oxymoron. He is an oxymoron, yes, indeed.
Yeah. Here at the Griffers, we're going to try the off-rack next.
Yeah, cheers.
And slam my car.
And slam that car door.
Slam that car.